Cottonmouth over here. You know, I was really impressed seeing how you battled with your Pokemon at the trainer school. And even back when you weren't yet a Pokemon trainer, Cottonmouth, you were able to save Nebby. You were chosen by your Pokemon so quickly. I understand why now. Oh, I forgot about Tauros. And Hau looks oddly delighted to be standing next to that Tauros. Oh, if it isn't Lily and Cottonmouth. Sorry for scaring you, friend. I guess it's time I get old Tauros back home. Oh, but why don't you give him a little pat first, Cottonmouth? Sure. All right there. Good Tauros. Good boy. You see that? This rascal already loves you. Pokemon become happier when we show them some care. Care, highlighted in red text. That's how important it is. Oh, the places you'll go, child. And as you do, you will surely meet more Pokemon and people who will enrich your life. The kahunas sure are something, eh? Able to calm a raging Pokemon without even needing to battle. Now that's something. I mean, I like Tauros plenty and all, but it is pretty scary. I don't want to ride on it. So where are you two off to now? I was thinking I should show Cottonmouth around Hau'oli City a bit. Nice idea. You're always on top of things, Lily. Cottonmouth just got here to Alola, huh? Yep, she's taking care of me as per the professor's suspicious request. Let me tag along too. I want to go get something good to eat. He's completely fine with being the third wheel. Alright, let's all go together. And what are we waiting for? This way, come on. First though, I really gotta heal up my Pokemon. Please. Oh, Hau. I guess we should go catch up with him before he gets too far, Cottonmouth. Hau'oli City is the biggest city in all Alola. Don't mind me, I'll catch up with you guys. So yeah, a lot of the moments shared between the main character and Lily are pretty much just shitbait, all of it. It's like she's always going out of her way to help you. And in the last recording session, you saw at the very beginning your mother and the professor trying to push the two of you together. Alright, now that I got everyone healed up, I suppose I should switch Arikari back to the front, because she does have less experience than Plague now does, and before I forget, I should really turn the experience share back on. There we go. The experience share is definitely more useful in this game than it was in X and Y. I mean, in X and Y, it was really, really easy to get overleveled. Same goes for Omega Ruby Alpha Sapphire as well. Love this music. It's so calming. So lovely. Anyway, as I was saying, yes, the experience share is quite useful in this game. It's not as easy to get overleveled, especially since there's a huge level jump at the very end of the game when you're about to fight the Elite Four and the final boss. So even if you spend most of the game a little bit overleveled, then you'll find that once you get to the Elite Four and Champion, then it's not so much the case anymore. You've come to Alola from someplace far off, haven't you? I can tell. Yeah, I suppose she would be able to tell. We probably get a lot of tourists around here. Let me teach you the proper way to greet someone in Alola. You just say the name of the region and move your arms in that weird gesture. Not weird gesture. I don't know what I'm trying to say to this. Definitely not a normal gesture, though. You'll make more friends if you say it. Yeah, I'm not too big a fan of how you say the name of the region as a greeting. Like, I get that Alola sounds very similar to how you greet people in Hawaii, which is Aloha. But did they really have to make it so that you say the name of the region as a greeting? It's all kinds of weird. I mean, who knows? Maybe in their native language, like, hello and the name of their region technically mean the same thing. I don't know. But I still find it really strange. The Wingull fly, and their droppings fall. Ah, the beauty of nature. Yep. Here we go, this one random NPC commenting on the beauty of Wingull poop. Ground-type moves won't reach flying-type Pokémon. They don't do any damage to them. Yes. I'm just continuing to talk to people. Searching for lore. Trying to get you guys, you viewers, really integrated into the whole Pokémon Moon experience. Look, catch! Would you stop? I know they're squishy, but that's no reason to throw Pyukumuku at me. Throw a Pokeball if you must throw something. And I'm sure Pyukumuku wouldn't appreciate being thrown either. I mean, you catch a Pyukumuku in your hands, and then I imagine it'd be quite irritated, so that when you come face to face with it, it spits up its innards and socks you in the face with them. That's actually how it fights. Which is a pretty nice real-life reference to what real sea cucumbers do. Slowpoke really has its own tempo, huh? It's never confused by other Pokemon's moves. It's also too slow to get confused or to take a hint. Leave me alone already, would you, Slowpoke? So yeah, for the most part, you get just random, useless dialogue with these NPCs, and I imagine it would get kind of boring if I continued talking to every person in sight. But, you know, occasionally they do have a pretty interesting bit of lore to share, and that makes it all worth it. And Hau apparently recognized the sound of my footsteps even after we just met a week ago. Or in game time about 2 hours ago. So that's a little bit frightening, if I'm honest. So what do you think? Hau'oli is something, eh? Alola's gotta be the best place ever to live. I'm not gonna deny that. The scenery here is definitely the best scenery I've ever seen in a Pokemon game. Oh yeah. Hey Cottonmouth, come in here with me. I've got a good idea of something you could do. This guy is so enthusiastic, and his enthusiasm is absolutely adorable. Hey miss, is it true that you can get some kind of special gift if you have a Rotom Dex? My goodness, you get the news fast. Hardly anyone has a Rotom Dex, but it is true that we have a special item to go with it. It's our very own Pokéfinder, here you go. Awesome. Isn't that awesome, Cottonmouth? You got a Pokéfinder. So, what's a Pokéfinder? He doesn't even know what it is, and he's already excited about it. That's Hau in a nutshell. The Pokéfinder is a tool that lets you take photos of Pokémon. Rotom will help point out places where you'll be able to take photos too. Here, I'll read you the instruction manual. Tap on Rotom or press R. Yep, that's all it says. Quite simple, isn't it? Man, that Rotom Dex is cool. It's like a whole nother partner, Cottonmouth. I mean, on top of your Pokémon partner. Oh, but I guess since it's Rotom inside, it pretty much is a Pokémon partner. Either way, you're pretty darn lucky. Meet you outside when you're done in here. The photos you can snap of Pokemon with a Pokéfinder, they are simply too cute to resist. Okay, I suppose she had to have the last word. Melee Melee Islands, Melee Melee Meadow. Say that 5 times fast. Home to wondrous bird Pokemon. That's what it says. Alright, I'll take your word for it. Mm-hmm. I know, look at you. You look like a Pokemon trainer with sense. I've got something I'd like to ask a promising-looking trainer like you. What do you say? Sure, why not? Oh, thank you. That's wonderfully kind of you. You see, I'm here doing some research on various Pokémon. I need to record the differences between 10 species of Pokémon for my survey sample, but I've been working so hard and my back is just killing me. But then you came along. You look like a sensible young trainer, which is just the sort of person I need to help me. I'd like to ask you to catch 10 different species of Pokémon for me, if it's not too much to ask, right? Good luck out there. So, yeah. Every so often we'll come across a person that has a request for us, and they will reward you for taking on that side quest. So I guarantee you guys, by the time we're finished with Melee Island, we will have at least 10 Pokemon registered in our Pokedex. So we'll have to remember to come back to this guy when we're done with Melee. So that's 10 Carrot Hill. Apparently only locals are allowed to go in. I wonder what kind of Pokemon live in there. Yeah, I wonder. We will definitely be visiting 10 Carrot Hill sooner or later. Cottonmouth, how? Did you visit the tourist bureau? How was it? We got his Rotom Dex upgraded. Now it can take pictures, too. What a wonderful helper you are, Rotom. Oh, surprise picture. Hau just looks delighted and Lily has no idea what just happened. What was that for, Rotom? Go and put that little trickster back in your bag, Cottonmouth, and follow me. Enough feasting for the eyes. It's time we take care of our stomachs. Maybe Rotom just wants to flaunt its new camera function and take more photos. Have you thought about trying it out? I think I'll go stop by the apparel shop to do some shopping of my own. Yo, trainer, look what you've got. Hello, random guy on the street I've certainly never met before. You lucky kid, if you've got a Pokéfinder, then I guess I'll give you a little tip. See that spot where the wall is cracked? It doesn't look cracked at all. It looks like someone straight up punched a hole through it. That's a photo spot right there. Okay. Your Rotom there is trying to tell you too. Give him a tap. Sure, I guess because this is completely mandatory. I'll go ahead and press R when I'm next to the photo spot. And Rotom is going to teach us Hau to take photos. You can move the camera all around by using the circle pad. It's always a good idea to try looking at the world from all different kinds of angles. When the time is ripe and you've framed the perfect shot, press R or the A button. Zzt. Apparently Rotom just said something very amusing because that Pikachu just straight up laughed at us. Are you just going to sit there, Pikachu, or are you going to do something interesting? Yeah, I think you can take better pictures if you catch the Pokemon in the act of doing something other than just standing still. Pikachu. Anytime you want to move, that'll be great. Screw it. Alright, now out of the 6 photos we've taken, we get to decide on the best one. And they all look quite similar. I'm not gonna use either of these two, because it looks like Pikachu is just being camera shy. I'm just going to use one of the more standard ones. This is the best shot I've got, Rotom. Everything's on the bottom screen, by the way, so I'll just read out the dialogue. Your photo's been uploaded, and the comments are already pouring in. That's a Pokemon, right? Whoa, cuteness overload. It's a pretty average spot. What a nice morning. Too bright. Did you really take this? Amazing. And we ended up getting 729 thumbs up. All right. Not much of a record, but I'll take it. You can get version 2 if you get a total of 1,500 thumbs up on your photos. I'm going to try for another photo shoot. Just because this is a fun new mechanic I want to show off. And it's a different Pokemon, it's Rockruff. Okay, so depending on how good the photo is, you'll get a different sound, a different little chime when you take the picture. So I'm hoping Rockruff runs up to me again, especially since I can't zoom in. Not yet, anyway. Oh, there we go. Come on, Rockruff. Here, boy. Or girl. I can't really tell the difference. Pokemon kind of gave up on gender differences nowadays. There was a ton of them back in Diamond and Pearl. And then they made a few more significant ones in Black and White and X and Y. But then they just kind of stopped altogether. And that makes me sad, because sexual dimorphism is a great touch for a Pokemon game. Makes absolutely no difference to gameplay whatsoever, but it does add a very nice realistic touch. Come on, Rockruff, one more good photo. It has nothing better to do than just walk around in circles, apparently. There we go. Let's see what we've got. Oh, that one's good. Not that one. Oh, I'm a little bit torn, actually. I think I like this one the most. It's pretty cute. Alright, let's check out the comments. Maybe if I could see more of it. My grandkids are cuter than that. It's just like Alola, but also kind of different. I'm going to bed. Look at those rays of sunshine. My mom thought this was a good one, too. Okay, I got 828 thumbs up on that one. And I managed to breach 1,500 thumbs up. So there we go, version 2. You got 1,500 thumbs up on your photos. That means you get version 2. Transmitting data. Please wait. Updating complete. With version 2, you can finally zoom in on things, you lucky little thing. Alright, that's enough for the photo shoots. That was a fun little mechanic that I thought would be fun to show off for you guys. Did you get a good shot? I hear it's best to try to photograph Pokemon from the front, you know? If you want to know more about the Pokéfinder, well, just keep on taking tons of pictures. There is actually another photo spot in Hau'oli City, and it's the spot near the guy that talked about Wingullpoo. So, yeah, there we go. Oh, Lily's just kind of hanging out there. What's up, Lily? Oh, Cottonmouth, tell me, do you pick out all your own clothes? Yes, actually, I do. I do pick up my own clothes. Of course. Most people do, don't they? I've always just worn the clothes that my mother wanted me to wear. The way she tilts her head downward like that, it makes her seem so embarrassed, and it just... Everything about Lily is just so cute and sweet. She's really one of my favorite characters ever. That's not why I stopped you. I meant to give you this, Cottonmouth. I received it inside the apparel shop here. I didn't even buy anything, but they said I was the 99,999th customer to visit the store. Not the straight up 100,000th, just the 99,999th. Man, that's a lot of nines. But I already have the same one, so I thought that maybe you might want it? This is what I'm talking about. Lily just straight up acts so sweet to the player character. There's no way you cannot ship these two. It's absolutely... I don't even have the words. And this is not the last time you'll hear me praising how cute the main character and Lily are together. They're definitely my OTP for this game. Okay, I'm just scrounging around looking for items here. Any stray things that people might have dropped. So there's a hair salon and a clothing shop right around here. Maybe I'll go ahead and change my look when I get to the next island, but for right now, I'm pretty fine with the look I have going on right now. Welcome to the scarf!
Okay. Alright then.
I mean, welcome to the apparel shop, and here, have this scarf. Sometimes the dialogue just makes you want to laugh out loud. A Pokemon with a silk scarf will find its normal type moves have more oomph than normal. Alright, she's just there to praise the ingenuity of apparel shops and hair salons. Battle Buffet, the crown jewel of the shopping mall, something I've never done before and I'm not really planning on doing. The more you walk with your Pokemon, the friendlier they grow toward you. Yep, no stray items anywhere, but there is a Pokemon Center up here. And a guy, just standing out here looking at the window. A journey is made by those who travel with you, and compassion makes the world go round. Let me share this with you, young trial goer. Heal Ball, thank you. Pokemon you catch in a Heal Ball will have their HP restored to its maximum level. They are also cured of any status conditions. Is that just a one-time thing, or is that every time you return the Pokemon back to its Pokeball, you know? Like, every time after a battle, when you go in to your party to, like, heal up their status conditions, you'll find that they're already fully healed? I don't know, I've never used Heal Balls, so I have no idea how they work. I saw those Team Skull Numbskulls loitering around the marina again. I reported it to the captain, of course. This is what happens when young people have nothing to do and too much time on their hands. What a bunch of useless thugs. All they do is drag trainers into battles they don't want and try to steal people's Pokemon. I heard they keep trying to sneak into the trial site to steal Pokemon to sell, and that they fail every single time. Alright, bit of foreshadowing going on there. Yeah, Team Skull. They're a thing. And, I'm not even gonna bother trying to describe them. I'm just gonna wait until they actually show up, because there really are no words to describe how great Team Skull really is. Okay, this house, we can do something in it later, so we will come back to it. But right now, is there anything else I can do? Yeah, there's some of the wild Pokemon grass that Ilima spoke to us about at the trainer school. How is it, Cottonmouth? If you're looking for good eats, you found them. Plus, Malasada make your Pokemon like you, and affectionate Pokemon are better in battle. Who could resist giving their Pokemon a few Malasada, eh? They're just so cute. Now that I've got some fuel in me, I want to go right down to the marina and scream out loud. Watch me, Tutu. No. Watch me, world. I'm gonna beat even my own Gramps someday. Alright. So how definitely has his dream, but he's kind of chugging along at his own pace. Which is what I like about him, of course. Malasada, okay, what kind? They're only offering the sweet kind. Alright, sure, I'll take one for 200 bucks. Oh, and I suppose I'll give one to... I don't know. Plague. He's my starter. Alright, let's have a seat. Time to feed your hungry Litten the fresh, sweet Malasada. Litten took a reluctant bite. Litten's affection went up a little. Okay, so I guess you can raise your Pokemon's affection by buying them Malasada. instead of just going into Pokemon Refresh every so often.